Once there was a king who was in the darbar sitting along with his ministers. All of a sudden they saw a strange person came in and did something which is very, very peculiar. He spread the carpet in middle of the darbar and slept on top of it. So everyone was surprised with this act. The king became very wild. What this strange behavior from a strange man? What does he think of himself? Nevertheless, he was inquired, "What are you up to? What are you doing?" To this the man said, "I came in, I thought that this is a Musafirkhana, a traveler's inn. That's why I slept." The king became even more angry. "How do you say it is a Musafirkhana? Don't you see it's a palace, it's a darbar, a meeting is going on?" So this, the man said, "Can I ask you a few questions? Can you please tell me who was living in this palace before you?" The king replied, "It was my father." To this the man said, "Where is he now?" "Well, he is dead and gone." "Who was staying before him?" "It was my grandfather." "Where is he now?" "He is dead and gone." "Before him, who was staying?" "It was my great-grandfather." "Where is he now?" "He's dead and gone." So am I wrong in saying that this is a Musafir Khana, a traveler's inn? People have come in, stayed for some time and have gone. Likewise, today you are here and very shortly you will also would have gone. Like this, in this world, we all come together as friends, relatives, fathers, mothers, sisters, brothers, for a short while, and in due course of time, all of us will depart. Likewise, this world, everything we get attached to, every relationship we enter into, is actually temporary. And because we invest a lot of time and energy thinking that these relationships will remain permanent, we actually invite misery in our life. So with this understanding, if we lead our lives that things are temporary and one day it will all be gone, we will actually not invite misery and pain in our life. We'll be able to lead life in knowledge, understanding that things are temporary. Hare Krishna.